So, welcome everybody to the 2022 Senior Art Show. We appreciate everybody for participating this year. It's great to be back and in person. I know the last couple years we've done it online. It was an excellent event that we did virtually, but we're happy to have you all back and in person and to see the wonderful work that you all put together. I'd now like to introduce Doreese Toon. She is our Director of the Department of Health and Human Services.
Thank you, Brian. Good evening, everyone, and thank you so much for being here. As I walked around and admired the beautiful work that's on display in this room, I'm just amazed at how talented our Hudson County seniors are. So I'm going to ask you to give all of yourselves a round of applause for the great work that you've done. And also, it's just so happy to see you in person, because we all know for too long we've not been able to come together in person for such events. So it is thrilling to see you in person and to be here too. So I have the pleasure right now to introduce someone who actually really doesn't need an introduction if you're from Jersey City or any place kind of nearby Jersey City. He has been serving our county for many years now, and he continues to serve our county with the same zeal he has served the county with from the very beginning. So, ladies and gentlemen, it's my pleasure to introduce to you our commissioner, Commissioner Phil Fodette.
You're too kind, and I have to confess I'm enjoying those cookies. They're really good. Make sure you get a couple before you leave. To Doreese and Ryan and North Great, we enjoy events like this every year. I was admiring a lot of the artwork. I like to write, but beyond drawing stick men and stick women, I have no artistic skill in that particular area, so I really admire the patience and talent that all the individuals here have demonstrated. Some really, really, really great stuff. So congratulations to all the winners, and hopefully we're going to have some state winners too. I'd like to find out who we get with the state winners. We'll go down to the State House and really admire it on a statewide basis. So congratulations to everyone who submitted it, especially congratulations to all the winners and to Doreese and our department. Please keep up all the great work we do for our seniors. Thank you.
So we are very lucky to have another commissioner with us to assist in handing out the awards and being present with us for our first time back here in person. Commissioner Anthony Romano is going to help us with the awards and the rest of the program.
Thank you, everyone. Welcome to the Brennan Courthouse. I want to say a few things before we start about the staff that's here. The director, Doreese Toon, is an amazing woman. After giving Jersey City so many years of service, she joined Hudson County, and she has her heart in her work. And I think that a good team is always led by a good quarterback. And Doreese Toon is someone who has a heart, who's always thinking of you all, and she has people under her that are just as phenomenal. And I want to say Joanne Northgrave, who's over there to my left, because Joanne and Doreese make a great team, and that's what it's about, veterans and seniors. And Bill O'Day, also that left, Bill O'Day, as myself, we believe that the seniors are one of the most important resources in the county. Other members of their staff that are here today is Melanie, and Brian Uhad, who is speaking before me. Uncle Lou is back there somewhere sneaking around between artworks. And we have also Rosa from Cultural Affairs back there, who is, her mother has done one of the paintings. As far as for my art talent, there is none. If you could go below zero, that would be me. So I admire all of you simply coming out and being here in this wonderful facility here in Hudson County. I'm speaking obviously on behalf of the County Executive, Tom DeGees, who is on vacation, and the future County Executive, the Chief of Staff right now, Craig Guy, and they both told me to tell you welcome and congratulations on all the wonderful artwork that is here. We're going to go to the first place for acrylic painting professional. first place, 2021 Keys to the City, Jimmy Fallon. Second place, After the Storm and the Calm, 2021, Joyce Sweeney. Joyce, where is Joyce? All right. Next, we have Acrylic Painting Non-Professional. First place, Ursus Maritimus, 2020. Cora Van De Broek. Second place, Charlie the Parrot, 2018, Julia Lombard. Okay, Julia didn't make it either. Third place, it's View of the Wetlands from the Meditation Garden, 2022, Sue May. All right, Sue. Dressed to kill him today. Congratulations on behalf of Hudson County. Honorable mention, Petals in Pink, 2022, Joan Brunner.
Joan's not here.
Next honorable mention, To Our Greater Glory, 2022, Acrylic Painting by Leslie Hagg. Leslie didn't make it. We don't have anybody for professional craft. We have non-professional craft. First place, Keep It Together, 2022, Barbara Henning. All right, boss. Next, Mixed Media Professional. First place for Bird Paradise, 2022, Danielle Fry. First place for shoes, too. Therese just said to me, find out where you got those shoes. Okay, second place. Magic Moments 2021 by Jim Fallon. John Garbo. At the Copa.
Remember that song?
At the Copa. Okay, honorable mention, All Lives Matter 2020, David Milley. All right, big lead. Mixed Media Non-Professional, first place, can't go wrong with this title, Women 2020 by Esti Maron.
Maron.
I've got all the pronunciations wrong.
This after living in Moravia for such a long time.
My neighbor, by the way. So now you better give me art lessons for sure.
There we go.
Second place, Clean Ocean 2020 by two people here, Karen Caratini and Beth Bentley.
I'm Karen.
Would you take for you and Beth?
Yes.
Okay.
Thank you so much.
Look there at the Joan. Third place, 2022. My Heart Shattered When He Died, Elsie Sinkowitz. Congratulations, Elsie. They're first. first place for professional oil painting, Sister Haley by Gerald M. Glover. Alright, Big Jack.
Hey.
Congratulations, sir.
Thank you.
Look there first. Second place, 2019, portrait of EKC, known as Artist's Daughter, by Charlie Churchill. Did I say it right, Charlie?
Perfect.
Congratulations.
Yeah.
You know, before I continue, I just want to make one other comment about the group that does this. This is the easy part for me coming here, but Therese, Joan, and all the ladies and gentlemen that are involved in this, they really put in a lot of hard work, and they should be applauded. I want to tell them on behalf of the commission, thank you. Okay, oil painting non-professional. Later on, you're going to tell me what the difference is. Somebody's got to know what the difference is. Dreaming of Ireland, Ann Marley. All right, Ann. Not going to see my results this morning.
I just got back. Thank you.
Second place, no title, Carol Kravitz. Going once, going twice. Okay. Third place, the New York City Skyline 2022 by Julia Lamba. Okay. Honorable mention is 2020 Children with Carrots by Calvin C. Palmer. Okay. All right. It's all the ladies that you're here, so the one that's all dappered out. All the ladies are all excited there, sir. Hold on. Did you hold that up? Let me get you a picture there. First place in photography, not professional, Rusted Piece 2021 by Harmon Kaplan. How did he get in here? Doesn't look like a senior citizen.
Thank you.
Who do we have next here? Second place. The king on his throne, Glenda Grandioso. We got an Italian that slipped in there. Glenda here? Please show some of us Italians have talent. I don't. Oh no. You look like Maureen O'Hara. Okay, Joe is first. Sculpture professional, first place, A Seated Woman 2021, Norman Darby. Congratulations, Norman. Sculpture non-professional, we got a double winner here. 2022 Mezuzah, A Prayer Holder by Harmon Kaplan. Double winner. A lot of work. God bless you. They want you again. Second place is another double winner. 2022 Songbird by Barbara Henning. Stretch. First place of watercolor painting professional, The Jazz Man 2022 by John Garbo. Second place, Sizzling Metropolis 2021 by Jim Fallon. Our first performer.
Same with
also in attendance, our Hudson County Sheriff's Offices will always maintain the safety of all our seniors and this wonderful structure. Thank you, officers. know that they're under the auspices of our Sheriff Frank Schilleri. Who is the senior? Watercolor painting, non-professional, first place, a place to rest, 2022, Anna Evangelista. Are you related to Mark, the cop? Are you related to Mark, the cop?
No.
Second place for Bear One 2020, Karen Caratini.
Thank you.
Next one is Works on Paper Professional, first place for Rose 2020, David Miley.
Yay, David.
I hope you're drinking soda over there. We're coming down to the last one, two left. First place on Works on Paper, non-professional, Beautiful Contemporary Woman 2022, Maureen McDonald.
Congratulations.
Last but not least, second place for Mixed Emotions from 2021, Sandra Samaniego. Okay, we have three more that just came off the, by the way, at the end we clap and congratulate all the recipients. This is the way I felt when I played ball. Yes, it's good to win, but you know what? You're in the game. To each and every one of you wanting to participate and to attempt to do a nice piece of artwork, you are all winners on behalf of us. Next, first place for print, non-professional, Kisses Broken 2022, Karen Garantini. Karen, you're putting a lot of mileage on it.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
The next two. One is for print professional called Billy's Blues 2022. And the other one is a pastel professional 2022. She walked before us. And you know the winner is the same, the one and only, Jimmy Fallon. God bless you. I could never sit still to paint for this many pictures.
It's nice of you to try it.
God bless everybody.
Again, on behalf of the county commissioners, I find myself always have a soft spot in my heart for the seniors because of all of you have contributed to this county, to this state, to this country, all your lives. And it's never forgotten by me, and I hope my fellow commissioners. And again, you're fortunate to have Therese, Joan, Mel, and everybody, Lou, that also feels the same way. Congratulations. God bless each and every one of you. We'll see you when I return. And now I'm going to turn it back over to Therese. Therese, where is Therese? Therese, director too, right?
Favorite job out of all the jobs that I do for the county. This is, I look forward to you bringing your artwork to us. It's for someone who has no artistic ability whatsoever. It is just a phenomenal occurrence for me to look at everything that people have created. I'm just going to make sure that you heard the announcement at the beginning. We would love to keep the artwork until the 19th of September. We hope that you will allow that to happen, it makes this courthouse so much better. And it's a beautiful courthouse by itself, but with your artwork, it just makes people want to stop and take a breath. And I think that's basically what we need. It's wonderful to be together. This is our first gathering, so we hope more to come. We just want to remind you, the art show is going to be held in May of 2023, so watch for the announcements. We will be sending it to you both by mail and by email. And everybody else, thank you so much for coming. We appreciate it.
Oh, my painting, it was a my next door neighbor. She was called Haley, and I call her Sister Haley. And she's a very, very, she's a woman that, very expressive woman and everything. And so I just thought, I didn't paint her exactly, but I painted her attitude, her mood, and everything like that there.
And what does the art show mean to you? Like coming here and displaying your art, what does it mean to you as an artist?
Oh, it's not a release, but it's good. I mean, it shows my work off and have something to do, that I'm a senior citizen. I have something to do, and I look forward to this show every year.
This started with me about 10 years ago. I've never drawn or done anything like this before in my life, and I belong to a veterans group, two veterans groups. One is we take our uniforms, cut them up, put them in a beater, make paper out of them, and then we do artwork on the paper. And the other group is a Sea Caucus group where I had been going for quite a few years. And a woman said to me one day, Jim, she said, I'm starting an art group. And I said, I've drawn nothing but stick men all my life. So she said, that's a start, come on in. And I went in the room and there was no real teacher, it was just different veterans at different levels. And we kind of all looked at each other and talked to each other, and that's how it all started. And all of a sudden I said, you know, this is easy, I should have started this a long time ago. But so after 10 years, I'm shocked at all the awards I've won. And a lot of times I don't feel worthy, but.
And what does the art show mean to you? Just being here, being around people, having to see your
I've been here at this, I guess 4 or 5 years, well, more than that. And luckily I've been winning awards every year that I come. It really means a lot. I got to know a lot of different artists from the area. And it's just great running into them and talking to them and looking at their work.
And we'll see you in May.
Thank you very much.
Oh, this is a lino cut. I go to school at the Jersey City Print Room at 135 Erie Street in Jersey City. And this is a lino cut, and I wanted to depict Marilyn Monroe kissing Joe DiMaggio. But the lino cut is very, I'm learning, and the process was interesting because you have to cut into a piece of wood. And then you print in the printing machine. So this is, I'm a watercolor painter first. I fell in love with watercolor painting years ago, but I'm doing more medium, learning more different mediums. This is my second year in the Hudson County Senior Art Show. Last year was my first year because I turned 60 years old, and my artwork was online, and this is really great because we're all back inside, and it really means a lot because when people see artwork in person, it's to me more important to see everyone's work in person.
And then are you going to be back here for us in the art show in May?
Oh, definitely. I'm going to create something else. Oh, you know, watercolor or a printing or maybe mixed media. I'm definitely gonna try every year. And I love art. Art has saved my life.